everyone, and welcome back to Curtain Up, my monthly video series where I talk you through everything exciting that has happened to me in theatre land this month. I said at the start of the year I was going to do these every 2 months, and basically life just got busy and I've got a lot of things to talk about, so they are monthly. As usual, pretty much everything has been vlogged, so if I'm mentioning something I'll try and have it linked up here and also in the description box, so make sure you check that out if you want to watch all of the stuff that I am talking about. Okay, let's crack on. The first show that I saw in May was Tick Tick Boom at the Park Theatre. This feels like so long ago now. I feel like this month, even though this year is going so quickly, this show feels like forever ago. It was literally the start of the month, and I went to the Park Theatre because I'd never been there before and I live really close to it, so I thought it's about time that I go and visit this theatre. I'm really glad that I went to see Tick Tick Boom at the Park Theatre because I'd never seen a full production of it, but I'm pretty sure that I have heard songs like done in concerts from it. So it was really exciting to see the show in full and see what it was all about. The next really exciting thing in May was that my friend Jake was over from New York City visiting London for the first time. I think this was his first time out of the United States, and it was such a spontaneous trip for him. So we met via Twitter, I can't remember what it was now, I put it in the video, but it was only like a few months ago, if that. And I said to him, I was like, well, we've definitely got to meet up, and would you like to film a video with me? And he very kindly agreed. So we did a whole big chat on Broadway versus West End, the differences that we have in our theatre lands and theatre communities, and just how everything, well, not everything, we talked a lot and didn't cover everything that I wanted us to cover. But hopefully when I go over to New York, we can do a part two and try and actually discuss everything. It was just so much fun to get to chat to him about the differences that we as theatre goers see in the communities. And I loved filming that video, and a lot of you guys seem to have really enjoyed watching it as well. So yeah, please do check that out if you haven't already. Another exciting thing that happened in May was that my favorite app, Todatix, had quite the rebrand. They did, yeah, just an entire rebrand of the visuals, not of the whole app, but their branding, hence rebrand. Wow, that was the longest way to phrase that sentence, I'm sorry. But basically, yeah, they changed all the visuals and it looks super cool. I love this app. I talk about it in pretty much every video. So sorry, but not sorry, because it's amazing. And if you don't have it, you should download it. And if you haven't got it, you can save £10 or $10 on your first use of the app, on your first booking, if you use my referral code, which will be here. And also it'll be linked in the description. Not only did Todatix have a rebrand, but they also invited me to be part of this cool blog post that they've literally just posted at the end of this month, so that'll also be linked in the description. It's myself, Sean, and Olivia, both of whom are featured in my recent videos, and like, they're so cool, I love them. And we gave you some tips on like your first theatre trip, or even if it's not your first theatre trip, I think some of the tips might come in handy. So it's really interesting that without any of us discussing it with each other, we kind of covered pretty much all of the bases of planning your theatre trip and what to do when you're going to the theatre and things like that. So it's a fun little post that we've been part of, so I'd love it if you checked that out. Moving back onto shows, something I wanted to do in May, because I'd never been there before, was to visit the Globe Theatre. As I mentioned in my previous Curtain Up video, I've kind of seen everything currently, well, now that some of the things have opened, I've not seen everything that I want to see in the West End, but I really wanted to try and visit different venues that I've been either meaning to go to or I've just never been to. The Globe was obviously one of these, so I went to see Nell Gwynn there. The main draw to see Nell Gwynn was that Laura Pitt Pulford is in it. She was in it, and she is an amazing actress. I love seeing her on stage, so it was a really interesting experience. I got a standing ticket to be at the Globe because it's the cheapest. It was like £5 and then a £2.50 booking fee, so under £10, which is a bargain. I think if you can do it, it is such an interesting experience to stand for a performance. I've done it, I think, 4 times now. Maybe 5 or 6 actually. I've just realised I've done some standing tickets at the Royal Opera House before, but to stand outside and potentially be a victim of the weather That was interesting. It was, yeah, an interesting experience. I said interesting like 5 times then, I'm really sorry. Okay, the next show that I went to see was another off West End one. I visited the New Wimbledon Theatre, which is obviously in Wimbledon, and I actually used to live in Wimbledon, so it was quite fun to go back there, and I went to see The Addams Family. It's their UK tour, I think the UK premiere of the show, and obviously, as I mentioned, there's a whole vlog for this, and it's really fun because I actually ended up bumping into loads of friends. I say loads, there's like 4 of us, but still, that's nice when you didn't think, well, I didn't think that I was going to be seeing anyone that I knew there, so it was really, really great to see the show. That's another one that I've heard snippets of from concerts, especially I remember in 2014 I saw Carrie Hope Fletcher singing Pulled, and after that I tweeted her and I was like, when the Addams Family is a thing, you need to be in it, and lo and behold, I saw her in it, so that was really cool. And yeah, it was really nice to visit the New Wimbledon. I think it's probably been like over a year since I last went there, so that was really nice. On a bit of a last minute decision, a friend offered me a ticket to Wicked, and I kind of couldn't turn it down. I'm really bad. If someone offers me a free ticket, I'm like, ooh, and I'm like, yes, please. So I went to Wicked, and I was hoping that Alice Fern would be on as Elphaba, but I did see Willamine, and you just need to go and watch that vlog for all of my opinions there. But in very exciting news, Alice Fern has been announced as the next principal Elphaba. Oh my god, have I ever seen Wicked? Like, Jesus. So that's exciting, and I'm really looking forward to seeing her in the summer. I think the cast change is going to be, I want to say, July 22nd. I could be totally wrong. But yeah, Alice Fern is going to be leading the cast as Elphaba, and Sophie Evans is going to be joining as Galinda. So that's going to be really exciting to see them lead the show. The next two exciting things on my list for May are actually music, just straight up music. I mentioned in a blog post recently about the Broadway shows that I'm hoping to see when I'm next in New York, and one of them was Amelie. Shortly after they announced the Tony nominees list, Amelie announced that it was going to be closing because it received a grand total of 0 nominations, which I was really sad about. And if you know me, you know that I like to avoid everything about a show until I can see it. So obviously, with the notion that I was like, right, I'm gonna see Amelie, I avoided everything. Like, I didn't listen to a single thing. I knew that Philippa Sue was in it. I really enjoyed the visuals of it, and I was just hoping, it just looked like a really nice show and something that I would enjoy. Thankfully though, to kind of soothe my heartbreak over not being able to see the show, the cast recording came out this month. So I've really enjoyed listening to that, and it's quite interesting kind of almost breaking it down and thinking like, right, why did the nominating committee not enjoy this show, and why was it not nominated, and things like that. So I'm slowly like going through now interviews and like sneak peeks of backstage at Amelie and things like that. So kind of become obsessed with it from afar, but very sad that I won't be able to see it on Broadway. The next album was obviously Rachel Tucker's On the Road. Do you know that I love Rachel Tucker? It's no secret. And I actually did a video like reacting to the album. It was my first listen of the album, so you can go and watch that if you'd like to. It's quite funny at some points, I think, anyway. I wouldn't really class it as a review, it's just me being a bit of a fangirl and enjoying the album, but I gave you some like insights into my history with Rachel Tucker. That didn't sound weird at all. So yeah, love the album, obviously. And if you want to go and order it, they're only doing physical copies of the album. It's not gonna be on like iTunes or Spotify or anything, as far as I know. So you can go and buy that now. Alrighty then, moving back onto shows. I took a trip back to the Savoy Theatre to see Dreamgirls because I loved it so much. The last time I saw it, I'm a very lucky duck, but through work I managed to get some tickets, and so I took Olivia along with me, and it was the show's amazing. It's so good, and it was really fun. The video, by the time this video is up, my Dreamgirls vlog will have just gone up. So you can go and check out who we had on, but we had some understudies on. I had another Effie White understudy, so I've still not seen Amber Riley, but that's fine. So yeah, it was a very exciting trip to see the show again. And finally, the last show of the month I saw was On the Town at the Regent's Park Open Air Theatre. I've been to two open air venues this month. That's quite fun. The weather has been amazing this week, so it was like the perfect time to go, even though I was terrified that with booking kind of far in advance that it was just going to rain and be cancelled. But I did have a very exciting visit to see On the Town. I'll explain it all in the video, which will be going up after this Curtain Up video, about what was happening. The show had to be cancelled the night before, so I was really worried that I wasn't going to get to see it on the day that I saw it, and it actually turned out to be such a unique theatre experience. As I said, all will be revealed in that video, so do check it out. I always feel really paranoid when I'm filming these videos that I've missed something major out. I don't think I have. If I have, it'll be mentioned in the comments, so go check those out. Talking of the comments, do let me know what you've been to see this month or what you've got booked for next month. I've already got quite a lot going on, even just in the first day of June. I'm not going to tell you what's going on, but I can reveal that I've already got a few shows booked and a very exciting event. And also, what else have we got? We've got West End Live, which is super exciting. I'm thinking of doing a video about like preparing for West End Live, and also I'm thinking of maybe doing some live streams from West End Live. So if you guys want to see a video about me, like my tips for like what you should do to prepare for West End Live, do let me know, because I think that might be quite fun to share. Talking of tips, I've just posted a video today, actually, when I'm filming this today, about my tips for stage dooring and how to have hopefully the best stage door experience. And I know some of you already are asking some questions in the comments, so I'm going to be replying to those today. So do go and check out that video, and if you have any further questions, I will do my best to answer them for you. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you've enjoyed it, do give it a thumbs up, and as I said, leave a comment telling me what you've been up to in theatre land recently, because I always love reading through your comments and having a chat about theatre. It makes me really happy, and I'm gonna get a bit soppy here, alright? I feel like this channel is growing quite quickly at the moment. I know it's still small numbers. I'm not gonna like pretend that I'm like at a million subscribers or whatever, but it is really nice to see people commenting saying like, oh, I've been watching for a while but I've not commented, or just having a bit of a growth spurt in subscribers. That's just really nice to know that my videos are reaching people and they're helping, or you're enjoying them. That just, it means a lot to me. So I'm really grateful if you are a watcher of the channel, and hopefully you're enjoying it. I'm gonna shut up now, but yeah, I hope you've enjoyed this video, and I hope you're doing really well, and I will see you very soon. Bye.